saying it.
Okay. Well, just do it.
Emma, what are you doing it?
Oh. Okay. Welcome to Fort Niagara. Thank you for visiting. Today, I am representing a British soldier of the American Revolutionary War time period. I am part of the 8th Regiment of Foot, also known as the King's Regiment. I'd be a Royal Regiment, and you can tell I'm part of a Royal Regiment because all the blue faces I have on me. You can tell any regiment was royal if they had blue on them. Now, away from the foreign stuff about the soldier and on to what everybody comes here for. What I hold in my hand is a flintlock musket. It is a brown vest. It's a 75 caliber musket, and it shoots a 69 caliber musket ball. The way it works is when I pull the trigger, this flint's going to fly forward, strike it, and scrape it down the steel, hopefully creating sparks. Those sparks then hopefully fall down into the pan, where it's going to be a small charge of gunpowder. It's going to hopefully ignite that gunpowder, which is then going to hopefully travel through a small hole inside the barrel, and hopefully ignite the rest of the powder on the inside of the barrel, hopefully shoot our musket ball out to help us American soldiers. Now, if you notice, I said hopefully a lot. That these guns don't always go off due to the long chain of events that needs to occur for the musket to fire. And also, the black powder on its own is very finicky. It does not like to go off in any weather or on a day ending with the letter Y. The way a British soldier is going to load and fire the musket is you're going to start off at the shoulder position and with the command of prime and load. Really then, bringing the musket down in front of them, reach back in the cartridge box and grab a cartridge. The cartridge at the time is going to be a tube filled with black powder and also contain a musket ball at the bottom of it. But for safety reasons today, there's no musket ball in here, and we're only using half the size of the charge that they would have used. And the reason there's no musket ball in here is because insurance companies don't like when our guests go home looking like Swiss cheese. Now, if you notice, my hands are full. How am I supposed to open this?
Mouth.
I'm going to bite at the top, trying to get a mouthful of black powder. From personal experience, does not taste the greatest, do not recommend it in any menus. Now, once I have the cartridge open, I'm then going to pour a little powder into the pan. I'm then going to shut the pan, secure the powder in place, so I can then bring the musket to my side and pour the rest of the powder along the cartridge down the barrel. I'm then going to remove my steel rammer and ram the cartridge down. And most importantly, I'm going to remove the rammer. As much as I would like to turn my enemies into human shish kebabs, they won't return the rammer back to me, and I'll be stuck with a very expensive club that won't be useful for anybody. Now, once I'm done with all that, I go to this position, letting the officer in charge know that I'm ready to fire. And once everybody else is ready to fire, we're then going to receive three commands. Those commands are going to be make ready, present, and fire. All together, it's going to look like make ready, present, and fire.
Everybody went wild to that one.
Nice. Thank you.
Thank you.